Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, my name is Siti Hopipa Aliskandar from 7B English Education Department of Universitas Muhammadiyah Bogoraya. And in this video, I will discuss three important points, namely the Grecian maxim concept or cooperative principle, and then the concept of humor or jokes, and the last is why people laugh at certain events or part of comedy or stand-up comedy films. FYI, this video was made to fulfill the midterm exam assignment for the pragmatics course with the supervising lecturer Mr. Rudy Haryono, SSMBD. And hopefully this video can provide more information and can benefit those of you who watch this video until it spins. Okay, the first is the Grecian maxim concept. In general, the Grecian maxim concept consists of four, namely maxim of quantity, maxim of quality, maxim of relevance, and maxim of manner. The first, maxim of quantity. Maxim of quantity is the maxim which a statement must comply with the limits of the information that needs to be conveyed, not excessive or lacking. This maxim is generally violated a lot when we answer question. For example, violation error. During Friday prayers at the Istiqlal Mosque in Jakarta, Nurdin, who is originally from Jogja, meet Mr. Mahmud. Mr. Mahmud specifically asked where Nurdin live, but he answered by indicating the order in which he will be spared when he moved, and even broke up his brother names as well. And Mr. Mahmud, where do you live? Nurdin, actually I live with Irfan, my brother, close to Monas, but because he returned to Jogja 2 weeks ago, I moved to South Jakarta and have been living there for a week. Actually, I live with Irfan, my older brother, near Monas, but the pain is that I returned to Jogja 2 weeks ago. I moved to South Jakarta and have been living there for 8 weeks. And then the second point is maxim quality. Maxim of quality is maxim of that is the maxim that the spoken word must be true and not make it up. Must be in accordance with the facts on the ground. The maxim of quality states, don't say what you believe to be false, and then don't say that for which you lack adequate evidence. For example, violation error. On Sunday, Dinas Devo named Erwin cried 2 times, but on Monday, Dina told her friend Linda that her nephew was crying all day long, not stopping. In some ways, the first of test point in the most basic maxim for the cooperative principle, communicating in good faith, seems to record that we are, or at least try to be, truthful. Yeah, the third is the maxim relevance. The maxim relevance is a cooperative speaker should not convey any information that is not relevant in the context of the utterance. The idea behind this maxim is that when we converse, we shouldn't introduce irrelevant topics. We try to stick to the topic of conversation, and we assume that our contribution will be interpreted in the like. Consider the following exchange. Are you visiting family this weekend? B. I have a term paper due on Monday. And a natural interpretation of this exchange is that B is saying that they don't plan to visit family this weekend, and that the reason is that they have to work instead. And then for the last is maxim of manner. Maxim of manner, that is the maxim which word must be clear and ambiguous. This relates not to the content of what you say, but the way you express yourself. And it's easiest to discuss each of this sub-maxim in turn, because they have a slightly different effect in conversation. Example of maxim of manner is it's possible the plane will be late. Simple positive suggests that the plane may be late, as this is often the case. It's not possible that the plane will be late. Double negative show that there is a rather minor possibility. Okay guys, the second point that I will discuss is about concept of humor or jokes. According to standard analysis, humor theories can be classified into three neatly identifiable groups: theories of superiority, relief, and inferiority. Okay, according to the standard analysis, humor theories can be classified into three neatly identifiable groups: the superiority theories, relief theories, and inferiority theories. The first is superiority theory. We can give two forms to the claims of the superiority theory of humor. The first is the strong claim held that all humor in full a feeling of superiority, and the second is the weak claim suggests that feeling of superiority are frequently found in many cases of humor. It's not clear that many superiority theories will hold to the strong claim if freezes, but we will evaluate as a necessary condition nonetheless. And the second is relief theory. Relief theories attempt to describe humor along the lines of attention release model. Rather than defining humor, they discuss the essential structure and psychological process that produce laughter. The two most prominent relief theories are Herbert Spencer and Sigmund Freud. We can consider two versions of the relief story. The first is the strong patient hope that all laughter results from release of excessive energy, and the second is the weak version claim that it's often the case that humor is laughter in purpose a release of tension or energy. Freud developed a more specific description of the energy transfer mechanism, but the process he described, it's not essential to the basic claims of the relief theory of humor. And the last is inferiority theory. The inferiority theory is the beginning theory of humor, since it seems to account for most cases of phrasive funness, which is partly because inferiority is something of an umbrella term. Most developments of the inferiority theory only try to list a necessary condition for humor, the perception of an inferiority, and they stop short of offering the sufficient condition. Theories in each classification focus on different problems and may draw often the answer to different questions from another school. For instance, while focusing on why we find something funny, Spencer offers a functional explanation and relies on the answer in generalist theories give the question of what we find funny. Okay guys, and the last point I will discuss is about why people like certain event or section of comedy movies or stand-up comedy. There are also many theories about humor. To seek a serious answer, for example, asking where does humor come from? Why can people laugh? What is the function of humor in personal and social life? Of course, this is as complicated as trying to find the definite answer about dreams, sadness, and crying with all its implications. This is because the problem is not only related to biological change when we laugh, are sad, or shed tears, but also in full-fledged psychological, sociological, and philosophical issues. In the realm of humor, there are at least three major classifications of humor theory. First, superiority theories. According to this theory, the essence of humor is a better, higher, or more perfect feeling in a person in the face of a situation that contains defiance or weakness. The emergence of a personal logging reaction because he suddenly gets a feeling of superiority when facing or seeing other parties who make mistake or experience unfavorable things. Many people log. For example, when they saw a clown who sleep on a banana field, they hit a pillar and was crushed by a ladder. In short, people log because they say expressions, speech, or other strange action that are considered as stupid. The feeling of superiority in the form of logger arises over the misfortune or lack of others. This humor model is often referred to as slapstick and is often used by many Indonesian comedians from the past until now. Many of our comedians use this style, for example, by deliberately presenting themselves as stupid, boost, or highlighting their physical deficiencies to make people laugh. I don't know whether the comedians consciously use this type because they are aware of who the audience is or if that this just their ability. Even talk this type of humor is considered too easiest to do. Okay, second is ingenuity theories. This theory explains that logger arises because of a sudden change from a situation that is highly expected to be something completely unexpected or out of place. Logger occurs because of frustrated expectation, so that someone from a certain mental attitude is thrown into completely different mental attitude. Thus, logger is a response to the perception of non-comorbidity. Okay, and the last is relief theory. This theory wants to explain how jokes can be used to reduce tension and stress. Well, if that restraint can be released, for example, talk with satire, people's feelings will explode in the form of laughter. In this case, humor serves to help relieve tension. If we often hear that humor is referred to as a relief valve, this theory roughly originates from. And this type of humor, in my opinion, still needs to be developed here. Of course, there are several other theories. Special moves for verbal humor are also being developed. However, whatever theory and tactics are used, the most important thing is honesty and a willingness to keep learning. This is necessary so that humor doesn't just provoke laughter, but also educates. Maybe that's all from me. Thank you for watching. See you next on the next video. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.